specifically welcome to my bed in my bedroom. I wanted to take you through my bedtime routine because I started thinking and I realized that I've put out so many morning routines on Instagram, on YouTube, but the reality is your morning is really only as good as your previous night's sleep, which is all predicated on your bedtime routine. So I'm gonna share with you mine, and I just wanna preface by saying I am not, again, some perfect robotic YouTuber person thing that does everything perfect all the time. I'm really not. But I do try and do a lot of these things a lot of the time, especially within the past few months. I've been really trying to be avid about it. So let me know down in the comment section below as you watch this video if you can relate or not relate to any of these things and any other tips that you have for me. Let's go to bed together.
Now this step really depends because sometimes I'll just wash my face while I'm already in the shower, but I already took a shower and I didn't wash my face for the purpose of this video. So I'm gonna go ahead and wash my face now.
So now that I've done that, I brushed my teeth, I washed my face. Another thing that's really important is wearing an outfit to sleep or lack of an outfit to sleep that's conducive to sleeping. And at least for me, using my body temperature significantly helps me sleep. So I'll literally go to the thermostat, I'll drop it down to 68, 69 degrees. Typically sleep dressed in my underwear, and I may or may not choose to wear a shirt. For this video, I'm gonna put a shirt on just because I feel like this is a little bit much. But it's clinically proven that you actually will fall asleep faster and have a better night's rest if your body is just a little bit cooled down. So keep that in mind. Me, for one, I would infinitely rather be super cold and snuggle under the covers than be hot. I just can't sleep that way. Okay, the next thing that I'll do is I'll either try and listen to an audiobook. Right now I've been listening to one called Ego is the Enemy by Ryan Holiday. Highly recommend listening to it or reading it if you have not already. Or alternatively, I'll do a quick little meditation on my Headspace app. Just something to enable a sort of mindfulness and almost a little bit of a distraction to wind down and calm my brain before I go to sleep. Let's do one together. This one, for example. Take 5 deep breaths by Headspace. Breathe in through your nose for 3 counts. And out through your mouth. This app is actually really great because they actually have a sleep portion of it, which just focuses on meditation and mindfulness exercises to literally help you fall asleep. So it's perfect for this video. And no, this video isn't sponsored by anyone.
The thing I'll do before I meditate or before I kind of take some time to read or listen to an audiobook is make myself a bit of chamomile tea. This really kind of helps just calm my body down. I love tea. There's something sort of therapeutic, and it's like drinking a warm hug. The only thing I have to be mindful of is that I don't drink too much because then I'm gonna have to wake up in the middle of the night and go to the bathroom, which is very intrusive to my sleep. The thing I wanna say really quickly when it comes to winding down, you really wanna set your room to the sort of peaceful heavenly escape, right? So whether that means having your warmest, most coziest blankets near your side, comfy pillows, you know, dress yourself in something warm and fuzzy, maybe light a candle, for example, that kind of fills the room with a really yummy, delicious aroma. Those sorts of things are gonna help to set your mood and tell your mind that, hey, it's ready to start shutting off for the night. So consistency and routines are really important. Your body kind of runs on this time clock, your circadian rhythm, and any sort of disruption in that consistency can really throw you off. So let's say, like, you know, you make a dedicated effort to go to sleep every night at 10 p.m. Just be really consistent with that.
Okay, so that was all the winding down part, right? And kind of calming your body. The next thing that I want to talk about are things to really prepare you for a solid day tomorrow. First thing is to journal 2 key takeaways, like lessons learned from today, as well as 1 thing that I'm grateful for. And again, this is something that I don't always do, and I kind of find like gratitude journaling to be sometimes a little bit forced or cheesy even, but I'm really trying to just be consistent and have a routine with this and, you know, see a month down the line if it's really helping. For example, today, 2 things that I have learned so far. First, I actually spend a decent amount of time, just by nature of my job, I spend a lot of time alone. I'm realizing that I need human interaction. What's been helping me recently is starting off my day with some sort of social interaction. I'm really trying to put myself out there and meeting new people, and just having one little social element really at the forefront of every single day has been helping me a lot. And so that's a takeaway from today because I did that today and I felt great. Second takeaway from today is that boundaries are really healthy to have, not only to protect yourself
because they ultimately define your values and define who you are and give you a sense of, you know, self-esteem, self-worth, but they actually are not selfish. Someone might think that they are, because ultimately they actually also help guide the person that you're kind of setting a boundary against, let's say like a toxic person. They're kind of guiding them in a more healthy direction for themselves, to hopefully not continue to hurt themselves or even damage other people. So boundaries are a win-win overall. That was another takeaway that I learned from today. One thing I'm grateful for is, this is gonna sound silly, but I'm really grateful that I'm not hardwired to be an angry person. I'm just not an angry person. I definitely skew towards sadness. That's sort of my like default emotion, but I'm not an angry person. So I'm really grateful for that.
Something that I'll do to have a more frictionless experience the next day when it comes to going to the gym is really prepping myself the night before. So for example, if I pack all my clothes and pack my gym bag the night before, then the chances of me becoming lazy and not going to the gym in the morning are much less likely. The next thing I do, conscious mind accounts for about 12% of your brain. The remainder is all your subconscious, right? So things that are kind of happening without even like your conscious awareness. Right when you go to bed, when you're in more of like a meditative, hypnotized state, and right when you wake up in the morning, to repeat out loud certain affirmations to yourself so they can really seep into your subconscious. So here's an example. I have this affirmation specifically for self-esteem, because I feel like that's something I struggle with a little bit. Radiate confidence and relaxation. I radiate confidence and relaxation. So right before I go to bed, I'll tell myself that out loud 3 times, and then in the morning, I'll do the same thing to really seep into my subconscious. Stay tuned if it works. Okay, the other sort of journaling exercise that I will do, and it sort of has to do with the same, it's the same concept of your subconscious, and really an ability to process through things that you're hung up on in your dreams while you're sleeping. Think about any really important question that I wasn't able to answer in the day, and write it down in my journal so that my brain, my subconscious, can kind of work through that and mull it over while I sleep. So there you have it, you guys. Those are my steps to winding down for the night and prepping myself for the next morning. It's a part of my bedtime routine. Hope you enjoyed this video, and let me know if any of this resonated with you, if there's something that I'm doing wrong, if there's something I should do better, and if there's something that you do that you think that you could kind of tip me off to. I would really love to know it. With that, I'm maybe gonna take a little nap. I feel in a very snoozy mood right now. And I'll talk to you guys later. Thanks for watching. Ciao, nos vemos.